This is Rick from JB Art Studio. I'm going to be painting a floral scene with a butterfly for Dena Tollefson's art challenge. It's an insect art challenge. I'll put it in the description. Anyways, I'm just going to get some liquid. I'm using David Jansen's paints. I'll show you. These, I just set it all up because it'll be all... I haven't used these in about half a year, so they all dried out. So I had to redo every one of them. But anyway, we have all different... I'll put them all in the description, all the paints I use. But I'm using his brushes also. He's a sable. What is it? Well, I can't read it, but... let's see. Whatever. I'll put that in the description too. So I'm just going to put some purplish kind of... This is his global art. Heritage Multimedia. Extended medium. I gotta get another one. This is almost empty. But yeah, so I'm just I dipped it right in there, and I put a little purple foam, and I'm gonna fill the canvas with just a little of that. This is gonna be. I didn't explain this. So we have a regular panel that I got that I made myself. I cut them out. This is a 9x12, and then I'm gonna add a little medium to this. So it's 9x12. I'm just gonna put a couple of drops here. Okay? Just spread it off. Just want the canvas a little wet. This is an alternative to water. It lasts longer and it can work, but. Sometimes you don't want that, sometimes you don't. I use different techniques myself. A lot of different techniques, so. And I pre-primed the canvas before with, it's like a beige color. It's an off-white, basically. So this is gonna. Basically a wooden canvas, it's just a like a Luan type of material. That's what this back panel is. Okay, so now I just mixed, I have some light red and some darker red. And I kind of just mixed them in. I'm going to put a little white there. Do a base color for one of the flowers. I'm just mixing with this 3/4 inch brush. Okay, now I'm going to get the duck mixed color. I'm going to put a flower right here. I'm just taking off some of the liquid, and maybe one right here. I probably don't need to, but let's see how that works. So I'm just gonna kind of put in some lines with this rose coming. And I get some of this. And some of the dark color in the middle. Thank you. blue in that. Purple color. I'm gonna make some stems like. Actually, I'm gonna do some green and blue, the brownish color. Leaves down here, some here, and a nice pretty butterfly right here. Clean off the brush. Actually, I'm gonna use some water to clean. But you don't normally, you don't want to mix water with this because it's not bad to do it, but you shouldn't. This extended medium doesn't require water, but just to clean the brush, it's fine, you know. Just wipe that off. Okay, so what I'm going to do now, I just got some green and black, and then I have some. Can you see that? Well, it's green and black mixed, and then I have a bit of yellow on the side. And what I'm going to do is introduce a little yellow into this rose. This up anyways. Not to mess it up. Yeah, I'm gonna do the stem after. I just wanna get some different tones. All right, I'm gonna do through leaves first. I'm gonna kind of do it this way here, kind of this way. Some black and green. Yes. Alright, let's get some white. It's a different tone here. I'm going to put a bigger flaw and overlapping this one. A leaf. And one over here. So good there. Yeah, happy accident. Okay. I don't like it too much. I'm not happy with these leaves, so... Okay, that's going on top of that one. Messy. It's coming off a bush of a bunch of trees and bushes. And let's see if I can get some different things from here. Background blurs. This one fits really light. And here, going this way. Thank you. this off a little. Alright. Excuse me. I'm gonna do some little lights. This is like just gonna some highlights going on. I'm gonna come back and do some negative painting. Get some of that green, that's quite pretty actually. Mix it in. In fact, I'm going to use mild red, dark people to me here. Just pulling that piece. I'm just going to soften it just like that. Should do that maybe. Just get it in like that. Just push these colors in. This goes this way and this way. Let's see. I'm gonna use number 7 now. What is it? Number 8. 8 flat. I need some white and a little red again. No, that's all right. Some red. Thank you. just playing back and forth. Trying to get the right effect. It's becoming a fur ball. I know where I am. I'm gonna pretty much start over down here. So, I need some purpley color. Actually, I'm just gonna put some tone in here because I gotta reshape these. Now this back one here is just a little further away, so I'm just making it pink on the tips. I might, well, not that far away. I'm just gonna try. I should be using a smaller brush. She's using the tip right now. Back to the white, redefine these little thingies, petals. So I'll see if I could make it swirl this way. Alright, now I'm gonna get the. We actually can use the number, what is this, 8 again. And I'm just gonna put a stem. All right. Okay, it's one of them. Okay. Now, I'm going to do the butterfly right here. The main attraction of this painting. Well, I mean, the roses are too, but it's more like this is for it's the insect the insect challenge by Dena Tollefson. So I'm gonna draw one. I can't draw it right now, but I'm just gonna plop it in. So I guess I'm gonna do streaks in here. Sun rays. Just gonna dab it in. Just the indication. To move the butterfly a little lower. It was just a little too high up here in the corner. So I'm gonna move him down here, overlapping this leaf somewhat. So he's a little closer into the picture, obviously. Okay, I'm gonna sketch this butterfly right over this leaf here. I'm pausing my camera, so I'm making sure it's not doing it again. Oh, so I'm gonna put a stick right over the top, and I'll touch it, and hopefully it doesn't squeeze in. I'm gonna use a black watercolor pencil, just so it doesn't do anything. All right, so we're gonna see how close I want this one. Gonna come down this way. That this part goes up here, and then there's a point. Like that, and then the big wing on the side. Coming around here like this. Hopefully you can see that. It's going off the screen a little. Oh boy. Alright, let me I'll readjust the camera in a second. I just wanna see if I can draw this out a little. Okay. Set it about like that. Comes down here, and go legs. Body. I'll fix that after. That's not. The leg is coming from behind. This will be. Okay. Alright, now. That's good. That's the placement of it. Ignore that guy. Alright, That's silly. I shouldn't have did that. I'm just doing some line work here. I'm showing through. I'll have to put it white over this. Fix the color after. I'll thin the blacks out. Because I gotta put white dots and stuff. Try a different. I'm gonna try to just put these dots on. No white dots there. It's turning gray, of course. Put some different color in there. Orange. Some yellow here. Some red. Probably gonna do this one more. She'll see. Thank you. No white.